morning students. In this video we are going to discuss about types of democracy. In previous chapter we have discussed about government's three organ, means legislature, executive and judiciary. Okay, in which we have discussed that legislature has a two house, upper house name Rajya Sabha and lower house name Lok Sabha. Okay, and president is an integral part of Lok Sabha, means president didn't took part in any session of Lok Sabha, then after he or she considered to be the integral organ of Lok Sabha. Okay, in simple term we have said that parliament includes Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and third is a president. Okay, next is a executive, in which prime minister and council of minister is included in this executive, and judiciary we have already discussed that in previous chapter Indian judiciary. So in this chapter Indian democracy we have already discussed about some important facts or points related democracy, means India follow democracy or democratic types of governance or government. Okay, but and most of the country around the world is followed democracy, but the system in their election is quite different between this country which is follows the same democracy. Okay, example in USA and India, in USA election is held on every 4 years. USA is also follow democracy and India is also follow democracy, but the election tenure in India is 5 years. Okay, so types of democracy, our today's topic is types of democracy. Various countries in the world have democracy, we have already discussed this point. There still exists diversity within various democracies of different countries. Okay, the country which is followed the same democracy, then and after the diversity seen in all of this country. Our country has a parliamentary democratic system. Okay, our country has a parliamentary democracy system, means what? All the decision of the legislature, or you can say a country, is being taken by Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha only. In a country like USA there is a presidential parliamentary system. Okay, here we followed a parliamentary system in which prime minister is the head of government, while in a country like a USA there is a USA followed a presidential types of a system in which president is the head of a government. We shall see in detail about the two types of a democracy. There are two types of a democracy. First is a parliamentary democracy and second is a presidential democracy. Most important question for your exam. Okay, so first line, our country has accepted the parliamentary democracy. Okay, in parliamentary democracy what is the difference is here, that in parliamentary democracy the president appoints the leader of the party who gets the majority number of seats. Okay, president appoint the majority number of seats. Okay, in general election the party which is getting majority number of seats in Lok Sabha, okay, after president giving invitation to this party's member to form the government, government, and in between the party member choose their representative, and which is known as a prime minister. Okay. Then after prime minister forms the government allot the different ministry to the different minister. The parliamentary government is completely accountable to the Lok Sabha. Okay. Means parliament is answerable to the Lok Sabha or particular party only. Government remains in power as long as it enjoys the confidence of the majority of the members of the parliament. Okay. Government तब तक ही power में रहती है जब वो confidence अपना विश्वास बनाए रखती है. Okay. And if government is not making confidence in their party, then the member of opposition party passes non-confidence motion. If this motion is passed, then all the party or ruling party has to give resign. Okay, because your party, aapke party mein hi confidence hai. नहीं, इसीलिए दिस मोशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मोशन नोन एज अ नॉन कॉन्फिडेंस मोशन. ओके, व्हाट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इन पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंडिया फॉलो पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी. सेकंड थिंग, इन दिस डेमोक्रेसी डेमोक्रेटिक सिस्टम प्रेसिडेंट्स अपॉइंट्स द लीडर हु गेट्स मेजोरिटी नंबर ऑफ सीट्स इन द लोकसभा एंड दिस पर्सन इज नोन एज अ Prime Minister. Now second is the presidential democracy. Presidential democracy is the second important type of democracy. In such a type of democracy, the president is directly elected by the people. Okay, what is the difference between parliamentary and presidential democracy? In parliamentary democracy, president means, in other term you can say that prime minister is appointed by the president, but here president is directly elected by the people. The president remains in power for a specific period as mentioned in the constitution. Okay, means in USA there is a 4-year time period, in other countries the difference is according to their constitution. Okay, presidential democracy is prevalent in many countries including USA. Okay, means simply you have to remember this, in parliamentary democracy prime minister is the head of a government, while in a presidential democracy president is the main head, and most of the country follow these types of democracy including USA also. Now election system in democracy, how election is conducted. Okay, and what is the role of the election commissioner. Our country has maximum number of voters in the world. We all know that largest number of democracy or largest number of population in terms of democracy is held on India. So our country has maximum numbers of voters. The election commissions maintains the administration, control and monitoring of the entire process of the election. Okay. Who head over the whole election process? So answer is the election commission. Okay, or in election commission there is one person name is election commissioner, which is the head of the election commission and give direction how to conduct election. Okay, it is necessary for any democracy that its elections commission is independent, impartial and autonomous. Okay, means there is no partiality can be seen in any country's election commission. It is mandatory to maintain the autonomy of the election commission. Okay, it is our duty to maintain autonomy, means it is also independent like which body? Judiciary. In the constitution there is a special provision for the terms and conditions of appointing the election commissioner. Okay, the head of election commission is known as election commissioner, and there is also given some specific provision in Indian constitution while government appointing a election कमिश्नर, ओके, व्हाट इज देयर क्राइटेरिया ऑफ सर्विस, देयर रिमूवल एंड और देयर सस्पेंशन फ्रॉम देयर सर्विस. द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड ऑथोरिटी टू होल्ड इलेक्शन फॉर द पार्लियामेंट, ओके, इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑल्सो कंडक्ट इलेक्शन फॉर पार्लियामेंट्स, वन, सेकंड स्टेट असेंबली, थर्ड लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल, फोर्थ प्रेसिडेंट एंड फिफ्थ वाइस प्रेसिडेंट. ओके, दिस ऑल पावर वेस्टेड इन टू द इलेक्शन कमीशन. ओके, मीन्स द इलेक्शन विच इज कंडक्टेड ऑफ पार्लियामेंट, स्टेट असेंबली, स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली, लेजिस्लेटिव काउंसिल, प्रेसिडेंट एंड वाइस प्रेसिडेंट. द इलेक्शन ऑफ कंट्री इज कैरिड आउट बाय अ सीक्रेट बैलेट. नेक्स्ट, लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली और द पार्लियामेंट इज डिसॉल्व्ड आफ्टर एवरी 5 ईयर. ओके, द मैक्सिमम पावर फॉर लोकसभा और इन टर्म्स ऑफ अ स्टेट, स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली, द मैक्सिमम पावर और टेन्योर टाइम पीरियड और टेन्योर इज मैक्सिमम फॉर 5 ईयर्स. ओके, आफ्टर 5 ईयर्स गवर्नमेंट और रूलिंग पार्टी इज ऑटोमेटिकली डिसॉल्व्ड एंड न्यू फ्रेश इलेक्शन आर हेल्ड. द इलेक्शन कैरिड आउट टू इलेक्ट अ न्यू कैंडिडेट टू फिल अ वैकेंट प्लेस ड्यू टू डेथ और रिजिग्नेशन ऑफ द कैंडिडेट इज नोन एज बाय इलेक्शन. ओके, व्हेन इलेक्शन इज हेल्ड आफ्टर एवरी 5 ईयर्स और जनरली, then this election is known as a general election, but sometimes the prime minister accidentally death and the other some reason they have to means opposition party pass non confidence motion, so in that case government means ruling party has to give resign. Okay, so in case the election which is held to fill vacant post, this election is known as a by election. Okay, this election is known as a by election. The date of election, advertisement, filling and scrutinizing the nomination form, the date for withdrawing the nomination forms, the declaration of the final list of the eligible candidate, the allotment of election symbol, okay, this all these types of work is being done by election commission only. Okay, from the time of announcement of the election dates, the protocol is implemented by the election commission. Okay, whenever the election commission declares election, okay, from that day to two months, okay, there is a some protocol is been implemented by election commission. The government is bound to abide by the protocol and not carry out any campaign activity, okay, which can affect the public opinion. Means what? Suppose there is a date of election is 30 December, okay, there is a 2 months left from year, okay. So what if election commission not implement some kind of protocol, so ruling party give a packages and different types of subsidy to poor and unemployed people, okay, because India lived in a, okay, Indians most of the poor are living. So what the scenario is being done is here, poor can give vote to the ruling party and that is also affect the public opinion also. That's why election commission implemented some strict protocol and all the government or ruling party has to follow this protocol strictly. The candidate and the political parties come up with their own election manifesto, okay, means if our party is being elected by the people and if वी आर मेकिंग अवर गवर्नमेंट, सो वॉट विल अवर नेक्स्ट वर्क विद इन 5 years, ओके, नेक्स्ट 5 साल में हम लोग क्या करेंगे, उसको क्या बोलते हैं, मैनिफेस्टो. सो एवरी गवर्नमेंट और मोस्टली रूलिंग पार्टी और ओपोजिशन पार्टी कम्स अप विद देयर इलेक्शन मैनिफेस्टो. द इलेक्शन मैनिफेस्टो रिफ्लेक्ट द प्रोपोज प्लान एंड द वर्क्स ऑफ द पार्टी इन टर्म्स ऑफ वॉट इज इंक्लूडेड इन देयर इलेक्शन मैनिफेस्टो. सो इकोनॉमिक रिलेटेड मैटर, डिफेंस, फॉरेन पॉलिसी एंड वेरियस प्रॉब्लम इंक्लूडेड इन दिस इलेक्शन मैनिफेस्टो. ओके, नाउ सीक्रेट बैलेट इन डेमोक्रेसी. इन अवर कंट्री इलेक्शंस आर कंडक्टेड इन अ कंप्लीट इंडिपेंडेंट एंड सीक्रेट मैनर. ओके, इलेक्शंस आर कंडक्टेड इन अ कंप्लीट इंडिपेंडेंट और इन अ सीक्रेट मैनर. वी ऑल नो दैट इंडियंस पार्लियामेंट्री इलेक्शंस आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी द लार्जेस्ट इलेक्शन प्रोसेस इन द वर्ल्ड. वाई? बिकॉज वी हैव अ लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी ऑल्सो. दैट्स वाई वेरियस पोलिटिकल पार्टीज, organizations and independent candidate contest election. Okay, we all know that political parties, okay, if political party is not there, first political party, okay, if political party is not there, then making up of one or two political parties is known as a coalition parties or coalition government. And third is, if you have not political background, not a coalition background, then one candidate is known as an independent party or independent candidate. Each of them presents their works, ideas and future plans to the voters. Okay, they all presents their works, ideas and future plans to the voter. It is expected that the voters vote without any benefit, greed or fear. Okay, इलेक्शन कमीशन सिक्योर्ड दैट एनी पीपल और वोटर गिविंग देयर वोट विदाउट बीइंग एनी बेनिफिट, ग्रीड और विदाउट एनी फियर. ओके, सीक्रेट बैलेट इज गिवन अटमोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंस इन अ डेमोक्रेसी. ओके, सीक्रेट बैलेट मीन्स ऑल दिस इलेक्शन प्रोसेस इज डन ऑन द सीक्रेटली. A voter has a right to maintain the secrecy of his vote. Means there is a secrecy of vote is given by our Indian constitution. So you have generally said that I gave vote to the this government and this party. Okay, so you should not declare these types of any voting matter because there is a secrecy of vote. नो वन कैन आस्क अ वोटर रिगार्डिंग इज वोट. कोई आपसे पूछेगा नहीं कि आपको किसने वोट दिया. द अमेजिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ इलेक्शन मेंटेन्स द सीक्रेसी ऑफ ईच वोटर्स वोट. ओके, इलेक्शन कमीशन फॉलोस अमेजिंग प्रोसेस. द इलेक्शन कमीशन फैसिलिटेट्स द वोटिंग ऑफ ऑल पर्सन्स इन्वॉल्व विद द इलेक्शन प्रोसेस एज वेल एज द आर्मी पर्सनल टू. ओके, इलेक्शन प्रोसेस इज ऑल्सो फॉर द आर्मी पर्सनल एंड दे फॉलो द सीक्रेट बैलेट पेपर, नॉट मशीन प्रोसेस. दे हैव टू गिव देयर वोट इन अ सीक्रेट बैलेट पेपर. टू प्रोसेस आर यूज फॉर वोटिंग. फर्स्ट, वोटिंग बाय अ बैलेट पेपर. वोशिंग वोटिंग थ्रू एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वोटिंग मशीन. ओके, इट इज अ टू प्रोसेस फॉलोड बाय द इलेक्शन कमीशन. फर्स्ट इज अ वोटिंग बाय अ बैलेट पेपर. दिस इज फॉर अ गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर, आर्मी पर्सनल एंड द पुलिस ऑफिसर. एंड सेकेंड, वोटिंग थ्रू एन EVM, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वोटिंग मशीन. काउंटिंग बैलेट पेपर्स इज मोर टाइम कंज्यूम. ओके, काउंटिंग बैलेट पेपर इज मोर टाइम कंज्यूमिंग एंड देर इज ऑल्सो अ चांस ऑफ एरर एंड मिस्टेक. सो दैट्स वाई नाउअडे मोस्ट ऑफ द वोटिंग इज कैरिड आउट थ्रू EVM, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वोटिंग मशीन. काउंटिंग वोटर्स इन EVM इज अ लेस टाइम कंज्यूमिंग. ओके, इट इज वेरी इजी एंड अ लेस टाइम कंज्यूमिंग. इट सेव्स टाइम एंड लेबर. ओके, इट ऑल्सो सेव्स टाइम एंड लेबर. वोटिंग बाय यूजिंग EVM इज एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली एज इट डज नॉट मेक यूज ऑफ द पेपर. ओके, ऑल्सो इट इज एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली बिकॉज इट डजेंट कंटेन एनी टाइप्स ऑफ पेपर लाइक अ बैलेट पेपर. If a voter decides to exercise his right to vote but not to cast his vote in favor of any of the contesting candidate, he can use the option nota. We have already discussed that. Suppose you don't want to give a vote, your vote to the any party, but you simply can cast your vote. That's why election commission comes up with one other option, name is a nota, none of the above. Then and after you can being counted to giving a vote. Okay, last, democracy and political parties. Democracy and political parties. India is multi-party democracy and hence we have various political parties. Okay, multi-party means there is, in India there is a regional party and national party. Also, specific criteria are fixed by the election commission to validate any political party. Means suppose you make a group of some 5 to 6 people and then go to election commission, declare our party as a national party. So there is a no possibility because some specific criteria are fixed by election commission to validate any party, the regional or a national party, political party. Political parties are classified either into national party or regional party based on certain specific policy, okay, and criteria which is decided by election commission. Okay, we have discussed that political party are classified into two types, national party and regional party. As per this, a party that secures more than 4% of the total votes in the previous general election in at least 4 major states is identified as a national party. What is the condition? Any party which is secures more than 4% of the total votes, okay, more than 4% of the total votes in general election, previous general election in 4 major states, then election commission declared that types of party as a national party and all other rest parties are known as a regional parties. As per the information given by the election commission by March 10, 2014, number is on 2014, total of 1593 national parties were register. Last year 239 parties were added. Okay, that we have only knows about two parties, INC, Indian National Congress, and BJP, Bharatiya Janata Party. But here number shows that there is a 1593 national party and also 239 is also added in that list. Okay, two major party here along with it, BSP, BASPA, CPIM, okay, Bahujan Samajwadi Party, Communist Party of Indian, Marxist National Congress Party, NCP are the other national parties which made INC and BJP. Apart from this, Shiv Sena, Trinamool Congress, Samajwadi Party, Dravid Munnetra Kazhagam, All India Anna Dravid Munnetra Kazhagam, Kalagam, Aam Aadmi Party, Janata Dal United, JDU, Rashtriya Janata Dal are regional party. Okay, these two and other means NCP, BASPA and CPIM is national party, while other party, these all DMK, AAP, JDU, all is known as a regional party. Okay, either your party is declared to be as a regional party or national party is being decided on the basis of how many numbers of vote you can obtain in last previous only general election. The party forming the government is known as the ruling party. We all know that the party which is forming the government is known as a ruling party. The party which forms the opposition is called the opposition party. But there is a certain criteria also. The party which secures 10% of seats, of total number of seats, means the total number of seats of Lok Sabha is 545, 10% of this is 54.5 is equal to 55. Okay, so the party which is getting a 55 seats in a previous general election, these types of party can form a opposition party. Okay. So, in today's context, in 2020, there is no opposition party in Lok Sabha. The opposition party helps form public opinion by democratically opposing the objections, plan and policies of the government. Okay, democracy's heart is known as opposition party. If this opposition party is not there, then the ruling party is behave like a dictators. Okay, but in a healthy democracy, it is desirable that the opposition party support the social and public causes of the ruling party, which are aimed at the welfare of the nation. Okay, in a healthy democracy, it is necessary that the objection and the social and public causes which is in favor of a public welfare, the opposition party have to support this. The success of democracy depends on a balanced relationship between the ruling and opposition party. They all know that effective and a strong opposition party is a prerequisite of a good democracy. Okay, effective and a strong opposition party is necessary to run the government or the ruling party being effectively. Okay, democracy is like a chariot, ruling party and the opposing party are the two main wheels of the chariot. Okay, democracy is like a chariot, one side there is a ruling party and other side is a opposition party, and that makes the chariot strong and very good, running in a very good manner. Okay, so this is the end of our chapter here, Indian democracy chapter number 12. Okay, I hope it is very clear to you all.